हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल?
दिव्या निवा अरे ना 1 मिनट
हमें ऑडिबल सर?
Audible, sir.
ओके,
So when we are going live, sir?
नाउ सर, जस्ट नाउ आई हैव मेड दैट टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम, आई हैव सॉल्वड इट।
Okay, sir.
So good afternoon everyone, and we are extremely sorry for this technical inconvenience, and hope we'll be completing it successfully now, and there will be some short duration might have been short due to some power failure and network failure over here. And I hope everyone is able to see my presentation. Yesterday, I hope we have completed with signal distribution. So if you guys have any doubt regarding this, you can just post it in the chat box, live chat. Clarify your all doubts. And definitely there will be some streaming issues due to the network issue and the power issue. Okay, so I hope everyone is online so we can start. First day we have stopped until the signal distribution OFDM. So how that orthogonal frequency division multiplexing has been taken place in the three axes like amplitude, time, as well as the frequency. And therefore, once whenever we are going to provide this kind of signal distribution, therefore it will be displayed or divided into multiple angles. So that particular angles only here we will be able to take, and based on that particular angles only the carriers or whatever the signals whichever we are able to send. So in that way we will be able to simulate and get it. So the same thing once when we go for this multipath fading. So this multipart phase, it is nothing but whenever the signal is being transmitted. So based on that particular transmitting section, we will be facing two sections. One is Rayleigh fading, known as loss condition. Riccian fading, non-loss condition. So therefore, once whenever we are working with Rayleigh fading winds, it comes under the straight line, and within that particular path, we will be in that signals gets faded automatically based on the distance technique. So in order to reduce that particular discontinuity only, the fade enabling technique has been done over here. Whereas the Riccian means we won't be providing any of the loss section. And whereas if you are providing this Rayleigh fading means the loss definitely will be occurred over there. So from that particular antenna, so you can see on the top here we have placed an antenna. So from that particular antenna, whenever we just provide the direct connection, so it will be switch what to say, without any direction, without any desired direction, there are many chances to go in a multiple directions. So that particular signal gets deviated whenever it is hitting an object. So what are the objects means? Either like tree or any of the building, and directly based on the person whoever accessing the mobile phone. So finally we will be able to receive over there. And the person who is receiving the signal, it can be completely said as the secondary path gain, and the medium of transmission, it can be said as the path relay as well as line of sight path gain. Okay, so in this particular way only we will be able to arrange the path fade. So through that particular direction, it automatically gets faded off that particular signal, but from another direction we will be able to obtain the signal directly. So these are that particular direction or the movement of this entire signal frequencies. Then comes under the guard interval. So within the guard interval, it can be commonly said as there are three sections like direct signal, reflection, and last reflection. And the final section is known as the sampling window. That doesn't come under that different sections. So sampling window is commonly used to trim that particular kind of communication signal, which and all. Affected with noises. So why this particular guard interval has been enabled means in order to protect that particular frequency for a required duration. So that particular required duration, wherever that white path you can see in this image, that is known as the guard interval. So that particular signal, it is able to apply the guard where no distortion or there won't be any kind of issues within that particular kind of sections once whenever you are working with the signal transmission or receiving. So this is known as the like first we will be modulating that particular signal, and using the signal processor we will be just directly sending it to the IFT, so inverse fast Fourier transform. So from that we will be inserting that complete sections. So using that particular transmitter, so based on that particular transmitter we will be able to get the phase shift, and from there we will be converting this digital data into analog. So after converting that analog section, it directly provided to the channel, and within the channel it will some of the noises also gets included. So from that particular noise oriented channel signal data, it is directly provided to analog to digital once again. This is for receiver. Okay, first I have whatever I have explained, it is for transmitter and this is for receiver. So in receiver, the signal with noise, it will be read by the analog to digital converter, and from there the signal processing section will process all the signals and removes the noise. And based on that particular noise removal, we will be directly moving towards the FFT. So during the transmitting side, we are using inverse Fourier. Here we are using direct Fourier. So from that, the power as well as the section will be created, or the phase shift will be applied. So based on that, the demodulation will be done, and we will be able to hear whatever that particular carrier was there. Like if the person was speaking through 5G network means, we will be able to hear the audio. If he was transmitting an image, we will be able to see it. So like all the systems or all the major domain communication can be done over here. So what are the particular process? So initially, once whenever you are working with this orthogonal frequency division, first the data coded in frequency domain will be provided, and from that we will be directly applying towards the transformation to time domain. Then we will be able to analyze the channel frequency response. So this was a complete section we have seen in block diagram as transmitter. The same thing if you're going with the receiver, therefore based on the time domain signal, the fast Fourier transformation will be applied, and from there the data will be decoded from each of the subcarrier. Therefore the end user will be able to hear the complete data. So in this way only the process whichever that orthogonal frequency gets worked. Now let us see how the long-term evolution like 4G LTE is working on. So within this particular LTE, you have five carriers, and within that, each and every carrier carries 20 megahertz of data. So from that combined into a single, like we can say multiple inputs and single output. So like a master or slave in that particular way. So totally we will be able to share 100 totally we will be able to share 100 megahertz. So that based upon that particular input, whatever the carrier is being taken, that network will be directly sharing towards the mobile, so that mobile will be able to receive the data. Highest peak data rates, highest user data rates, more capacity of typical busty usage, leverages all spectrum assets. So these are the which you will be able to see through the carrier aggregation in the 4G. So students, if you have any doubt, tell this, you can just post it in chat box. So just I will turn on the matter up now itself. So once, what are the antennas they are using inside the LTE means the MIMO, like multiple input and multiple output. So in this way we will be having different sets of improvements, which can be commonly said as leverage wider bandwidth, leverage more antennas, and leverage head nets. So these are the different sections. So leverage wider bandwidth only, now we have seen the multiple carriers and the single output will be there, which provide the high data rates. The same thing if you go for leverage more amount of antennas, like MIMO means multiple input and multiple output. So they are keeping around 4x4 or 8x8. So this will be the default size whichever they keep, like four transmitters and four receivers in that way. And therefore, once whenever we provide this leverage more antennas, what are the benefits means? This have high spectral efficiency. So whenever we communicate, therefore we will be able to send the data clearly without any kind of shortage or whatever kind of situation which we are facing currently. And therefore, like once whenever we go with the leverage head nets antenna, so this can be completely applied with advanced interference management. So this cannot be commonly applied to all the mobiles, maybe for any of the optical fibers or any other communication such as receiving for internet connections in that small cell range expansion. So in that way only they will be able to create it. What are the benefits means? The high spectral efficiency per coverage area. So for a required coverage area, you will be able to particular spectrum only we will be able to work. Is everyone audible?
Yes, sir, audible.
Okay, fine. So generally, once whenever you are working in the carrier aggregation, we have to check what are all the frequency carriers and what are the carrier aggregation. So based on this, aggregation means how that complete load has been analyzed with the partial loaders, and based on that, in which meeting point we will be able to approach that particular gained capacity of the signal. So whenever we work regarding towards the carriers, normally the single carriers will be having 10 megahertz and carrier aggregation, which contains a group of carriers. So that particular section will be having totally 20 megahertz. So based on that particular expansion only, we will be able to work around it. So these are LTE bands, and these are the LTE bands which has been applied in different countries like North America, Europe, China, Japan, India, South America, and Australia. So most of the places who are all using LTE, they commonly use this LTE 700, and the same LTE 700 only we are also using for communication purpose inside the Qualcomm processor, which can be commonly said as in all the Android mobile phones, because basically what all the Android mobile phones nowadays we are purchasing, it is based on the Qualcomm processor, and their processor has a certain frequency to receive the signals from this particular antenna. Where company are buy 5G spectrum? Like, it is not like a buying of a frequency. We have to generate that particular frequency, and if the frequency has not any of the issues, means definitely based on that particular frequency we will be able to release it for multiple sections. Usually the high frequency sections everyone all will be using, means they can, it can be listed as HAL, DRDO, then we can go with ISRO. So these are all the some of the industries will, and the Indian military, Indian Navy. So these organizations definitely use high frequency. So whenever we are interrupting, for example, the real time, whatever I have faced, means once if you are going from going within the place of this kind of HALs or DRDO sections in Bangalore, means your phone signal gets automatically cut, I mean disconnected. So you won't be able to just speak or connect the call. Definitely their range itself, it is beyond the kilometers. So until, unless if you are coming out of their particular space, we won't be able to access our user's mobile. So that much amount of frequency they are providing. And I hope the screen is not shared. And I hope now it is visible. So definitely once whenever you are working in this LTE in license spectrum, means they will be able to share the gigahertz from 700 megahertz to 3.8 gigahertz. Whereas if you are using any of the unlicensed spectrum, therefore the 5 gigahertz they will be able to share through the carrier aggregation. So what is this TDD and FDD? It is nothing but time division duplex and frequency division duplex, where the channel will be able to share the complete data from this time division section And from that particular time division section, you will be having various transmitting and receiving sections. For each and every transmitting and receiving, you will be having a gap of baud interval in order to provide prevent from distortion problems. Whereas if you go for frequency division, means the same transmitting and receiving, based on the channel spacing, the frequency will be allocated. Here, it completely depends based on the timing, like 0.5 seconds or 1 second. So within 1 minute, this many calls we will be able to connect. So in that particular motor only, we can say this TDD. So what is this beamforming technology? So MIMO with 8 to 12 antenna, they will be providing the beam as the rays. So this particular rays only, we can say it as the signals, whatever we required for our complete communication purpose. So based on that particular wireless multiple input and multiple output, so you will be from within a tower, you will be able to get the multiple signals, and that signals you will be able to receive into your laptop or system, either as internet or any of the call connection. So this particular beam directly approaches as a communication section based on the 4x4 size, which varies from 8 to 12 antennas. 4x4, it can be commonly said as an array batch. So now currently whatever we are using, it completely comes under the sections of wireless fidelity. Based on that particular, we will be able to share that complete data in a circular manner, 360 degree. So 360 degree, all the places it will be able to distribute the signal. Whereas if you go with beamforming, means wherever we are applying that communication or requirement of that technology section, we will be able to share the data instantly over there. So what are the different types of antennas available for this kind of communication? Means single input, single output, single input, multiple output, multiple input, single output, multiple input, multiple output. So based on this only we will be able to work. So whenever they were able to work with this multiple input and multiple outputs, and only we were able to start with our con calls or multiple messagings in that way. So these are the comparison analysis between the multiple users under the station. So it depends upon, or it varies according to the people who want to use which each type of antenna or each type of application over there. So let me quickly complete this. Next, so this cognitive radio networks, it is nothing but the radio network which has been switched surrounded with multiple nodes. So based on that particular nodes only, we will be able to initialize the radio frequency, and from that frequency only we will be able to share the data. So this is a type of wireless communication which comes under the RF spectrum, which also can be said as a minimizing the interference of the users, like connecting to the wrong calls, or it can also be said as a joint call in that way, like interference calls. So to prevent that, only the cognitive radio networks based on the radio frequency they have initiated, and from that section only we will be able to apply it. So here we will be able to see that complete nodes, so in which way it is getting transmitted and which way it is able to getting received, and what are the three sections means. One is the primary network station, primary network user, and secondary network user. So even multiple people also use the networks based on this communication channel, there won't be any of the interference. So in this way only we'll be able to work it out. And nowadays I hope many of them are feeling that. If you are just talking with any of your friends, means in between there will be some kind of wrong calls connected automatically and they will be speaking something. So in that way, to avoid that kind of interference, they have applied this CR network, which is known as cognitive radio network, where the base station will be placed at each and every place. Opportunistic spectrum sensing, it is completely based on the analysis of spectrum based on the time, power, as well as the frequency. So wherever the particular gap has been filled, it is known as the spectrum analysis has been enabled over there. And the block section means in that places we won't be able to access the network. So these are the applications of this antenna arrays where we work with complete MIMO with multiple networks, like leverage other radios to affect an internet antenna array. So based on that, we will be having first hop and second hop, where first hop belongs to the source cluster and second hop belongs to the destination cluster. In between, we will be having the antenna, which is known as relay cluster. Based on triggering as well as activate option, we will be able to communicate the data. So where we can apply means vehicular coverage, backbone communication for mesh networks, range extension with the cheaper devices. So to extend the ranges or to communicate between two vehicles, in that places we can apply this antenna. What are the issues you will be facing once you are working on it means timing, mobility, coordination, and overhead section. So these are the issues we will be facing it. Based on this, that particular communication has been changed and the allocation can be done in this particular way. So one set will be having the licensed and another set will be having the unlicensed, and based on this licensed and unlicensed base station, we will be able to interact with each other with that each and every kinds of sections. So as my power is OFDM. So here we will see that what will be the water fill level for OFDM, like which can also be set as underwater connections. So here the MATLAB is ready. With cognitive radio networks. So here I have applied the CRN calculation for noise ratio. And then comes with the noise power section. So that will be the input section of this particular noise. Then comes with the iterative water filling. So water filling, it is nothing a mode of section. Like yesterday we have seen one example how that particular water fills with the sub channels. So the same demo only we are going to see with the OFDM section. OFDM So the power also gets automatically allocated over there. And I hope. Yes. Athena, how can I help you? Athena, are you able to hear? Okay, then if anything means you can just message. Yeah, so based on this particular OFDM water filling, we will be able to check how many power has been allocated to sub channels and how many carrier ratios are also provided over there. So yeah, the mic is turned down already. Sir, ma'am, you are asking with Athena, sorry. Okay, fine. So based on that particular channels only, now we are going to simulate this. Now I'm going to run. Okay, so just a minute, let me check with that input section. Yeah, sorry, I have opened that supporting code. So that water filling section only, now we will be calculating the CRM. So here we might have applied that all the filters and subcarriers over there. So until the iteration stops, all the calculation will be done. And here that basic OFDM water filling will be applied. Like the red color is known as the power allocated to the subchannels to balance it. And whatever the noise which has been sent to the carrier section. So this will be the basic OFDM water filling technique with the ratios of noise to the carrier as well as how much sub channels within our system. So in this way only we'll be providing the section, and this code, whatever I have first explained, it is for water filling application. And the second one is which carries the subcarrier's data. So here the subcarrier data I have given it as 4, and the channel has been created in the ratio of 1:1:4. So based on that, we will be able to equally divide that complete section by using that Rayleigh fading method only here we have applied. And the filter, it is nothing but to remove the noises based on the interval section. And finally, this will be able to calculate the rectangular length of each and every application. And that rectangular length only you have seen as a plot. I mean, while running this particular code, you might have seen this plot. So based on that particular section only, it has been completely analyzed and changed over there. So guys, is there any doubt? Thank you. And we have doubt, you can just post it in chat box.
No, sir.
Okay. Tamil salon, sir.
Yes, sir.
Wind up panikalama, sir.
Okay, sir. So, either ipo yara rendu per da kekkalama, sir.
Pulla, sir.
Small QA. Only one question.
Okay.
Nandri will ask the question now.
Okay.
Yep.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes.
I would like to request resource person enlightened Satomi. Why some countries are banned 5G technology? Possible?
Yeah, the most probable reason that whichever they have banned, it is nothing but the frequency radiation. And what is the main problem is many of the persons, those who are currently who and all using this 4G or 3G, they are also facing some problems. And due to this, there are many scarcity of birds. I mean, complete birds, or we can also say any of the animals, they are most affected to this. That is the main reason.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. So keep ready. So when you complete the sequence, she will compare the validity. So am I audible?
Yes, sir.
So you complete the solution, right? I will compare it, the validity.
Yeah, okay, sir. Okay.
Sir, can I start now?
Validity, sir, is it the session over, sir?
There was an interruption. Hello, am I audible, sir?
Yes, you are audible.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir, for your wonderful lecture. Hope our students are completely benefited. The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams. Now, it's time for the validity address. For this, I would like to welcome Dr. P. Gayatri Madam, Head Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Application, Rajiv Gandhi Arts and Science College, for validity address.
Good afternoon, everybody. I am pleased to thank the principal, Rajiv Gandhi Arts and Science College, to organize the wonderful workshop, an online workshop. May I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
And I would like to thank the working partner for conducting, that is Pantech e-learning, for conducting a wonderful and upcoming topic for our computer science community. So they will be very useful. This topic will be very useful for our students. the Pantech e-learning resource persons is very well given an introduction and explanation about architecture to algorithm and algorithm to implementation. That is what our students are learning from low level programming to low level designing to high level to a product. So it will be very useful for the students. So students, for the UG students, most of the terms will be not familiar for you, but take this opportunity as a new learning for your learning stone for your future. So thank you. And I wish and I congratulate Dr. Tamil Selvam for organizing this wonderful workshop and introducing Pantech to our organization. And I wish to thank all the participants, students, and as well as the faculty members all over India for making this event as a successful one. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Science isn't about why, it is about why not. So it's time to raise queries and to share our feedback. With this thought, I would like to welcome the participants to share their views and feedback about this workshop. First, I would like to welcome Revathi Madam, Assistant Professor of Computer Science, Rajiv Gandhi Arts and Science College, to share the feedback.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Revathi, Assistant Professor of Computer Science. This is the first 2 days virtual program organized by our department. Hope this is a stepping stone which will be helpful to organize many more programs for the welfare of the students. So we literally have learned many new things about this new technology, because what we see today is a sophisticated world of technology with the innovation and advancement. We can feel these advancements, especially in the field of telecommunication. From 1G to 5G, the world of telecommunication is totally changed. And now the aim of such industries is to furnish the best of the best services to the customers. So we are in need to learn more about this booming technology. In-depth knowledge of this workshop opens our minds to a new technology, which covers about the bandwidth, features, its parameters, and clearly about its types and about the wireless evaluation. I think this 5G technology will have a huge demand in future. The resource person was way of delivering the content and the preparation of slides relevant to the content is very clear, and especially resource person indeed needs great appreciation. Sir, waiting for some more programs from Pantech e-learning in future to acquire more knowledge. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to welcome Ramya.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Ramya from BSc Second Year Computer Science from Rajiv Gandhi Arts and Science College. Thanks for giving us a beautiful lecture about 5G wireless communication. It was really easier to understand, and the speech was very eager to listen. Especially the way of conducting classes was very good. It was Kinley designed course. Waiting for some more lecture to acquire knowledge. Once again, thanks for giving us a beautiful lecture about a 5G wireless communication. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Ramya. Next on the list is Divya.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Divya of 3rd BSc from Rajiv Gandhi Arts and Science College. Thanks in loads, sir, for giving us a fabulous speech on workshop on 5G wireless communication. This workshop was really useful to us, sir. These two sessions was an eye-opener for the students who wish to opt these fields. Once again, thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, Divya. Now I would like to welcome Rahul.
It was really an amazing workshop. We literally have learned many new things about 5G technology. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rahul. Next on the list is Jay Kumar.
I hope that Jay Kumar has some net issues. Let's begin with Adina. Now I welcome Adina.
Hi sir, good afternoon. I'm Adina from Perindale Commerce Arts and Science College. The program was very nice and good communication between 5G. I learned a lot in this program. Thank you for communication. Be linked with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Adina. Finally, I would like to welcome Nandini.
I'm Nandini, BSc Computer Science from Rajiv Gandhi Arts and Science College. Thank you, sir. Thank you for very wonderful explaining about 5G technology. Now, currently, we are using 4G technology, right, from 2 years, and now it's time for 5G. 5G will come late in so many countries, but fact is that 5G will be faster than imagination. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Nandini. Thank you all for all your valuable feedback. Feeling gratitude and not expressing it is like wrapping a present and not giving it. For this, I would like to welcome Dr. D. Tamil Selvam, sir, Assistant Professor of Computer Science, Rajiv Gandhi Arts and Science College, for a vote of thanks.
Good afternoon, and all. It's a privilege to bid the vote of thanks for this 2 days workshop on 5G wireless communications. Every beginning has an end, and so today we have come to the end. So, when we started this workshop, we are in our mind that we should give some intro for beginners and of course for some advanced information about 5G, and hope that it fulfilled from the messages we received from the feedback. We can assume that we have tried to fulfill the agenda. Now, so I would like to bid the formal vote of thanks. I take this opportunity to thank our beloved principal, Dr. Arjunan sir, the inspirational leader under whose guidance the workshop was made possible. I owe my gratitude towards him. Our head of the department, Dr. N. Nyanamiga ma'am, Department of Computer Science, who is the backbone of this workshop. Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to thank Dr. P. Gayatri ma'am, the head of the Department of Computer Applications, the convener of this workshop, who have made this workshop possible. I take this opportunity to thank Sri N. Srinivasan, Director of Pantech Learning, and his team, Sri R. Kumaraswamy, Sri M. R. Tendulkumar, and the research person for this evening, Sri Vishnu Radhakrishnan. Thank you, sir. Here I do have to say something. Now, Pantech Learning have been doing this type of workshop for the past 4-5 months. In the pandemic situation, they were giving a wonderful platform for all the higher education students and education institutions to impart knowledge. I thank them for the same. Now comes the real backbone of this workshop, you, the real participants from different parts of India. So we have received around 500 plus registration. I do have to note this thing, why 500 plus, because yesterday morning I got messages that all the seats were filled and more people want to just join this workshop. So it's a very, we are very much gratitude to say that we have reached the audience in bigger day. I thank the students and the professors from Rajiv Gandhi Arts and Science College, the affiliated colleges, and all the participants who have attended this workshop. I hope we gained a detailed insight in the domain of 5G. Thank you, Ananda. Back to you, Geeta.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all participants for providing this wonderful opportunity to Pantech e-learning. Definitely, you can contact us any kind of requirements for your technical assistance for us. You can log into Pantech e-learning page, and if you are interested to attend our further webinars, you can just approach us through Pantech e-learning site. So all the details has been provided over here, and thanks to all for your valuable attention to this particular program. So thank you all. Sir, shall we end the